Hello and welcome to the Lean Discovery video series, where we're going to be tackling head on the issues faced by litigants around the country and around the globe as regards the coronavirus crisis. It's affected court deadlines everywhere, and litigation budgets have been impacted by the economic downturn. My name is Clinton Sanko. I'm the eDiscovery officer and a shareholder at Baker Donaldson, and I have with me today as a guest, Dave Dobson from Epiq Global. Welcome, Dave.
Good afternoon, Clinton. Great to be with you. Thanks for inviting me. Your firm has been an incredible partner for Epiq over many years, and it's a real delight to be with you today.
You've mentioned several times kind of the suite of services that Epiq provides across the EDRM. And of course, you guys have technology and staffing resources attended to address each of these different issues that clients face. One of the interesting things about talking to you as the CEO is everything kind of rolls up to you within the organization. And I'm curious, if you were to look at the last several months or the, you know, six months to a year, what are you hearing from your operations teams as like really good, innovative, next level services or technology options that are being underutilized and represent significant opportunities for more efficiencies, for cost savings, and for quicker defensible results?
Yeah, I did allude to this a bit earlier that I don't feel like I'm being successful unless I'm spending probably 20-25% of my time in front of our customers. So whether it's our law firm clients like yourself, or your clients, which are the corporate general counsel teams. And I learn a lot from those teams. And so I was out for dinner once with one of our largest clients. This is a very large technology firm based in Silicon Valley. And so I was out with the lead eDiscovery executive of that company. And she was describing to me how their processes over time have been divided across many providers. And we were given an opportunity in 2019, now leading into 2020, to actually provide a range of services. We made a commitment that if we had an opportunity to look at the entire extent of the services that they were consuming, we would make a commitment to reduce the cost of those services by 20-25%. And I can tell you that 5 months into 2020, not quite, we're delivering on that commitment. So how we're doing that, so what we're seeing from the front lines and what our teams are telling us is, and I know this might sound like a bit of a cliche, but the first thing is really leveraging technology like machine learning or artificial intelligence, products like NextLP or BrainSpace. These are really powerful tools that have the capability to significantly, cull down and make the review process much more efficient. Second, I talked about, which is information governance. We've built up a set of solutions and consultants that can help our clients. How do you deploy more effective information or data management and data systems such that when you have, what information do you hold on to when you need to extract that information? How do you do it highly efficiently? And that's a part of our business that's growing rapidly. And we think the most forward leading customers see that as well. The third area is particularly relevant for law firms. And it's interesting, there's a segmentation that's going on that we see, which is you'll see law firms that have chosen to be in the business of providing e-discovery or doing document review. And our view is, that's fine. The competition is great. But we're also seeing firms, and they probably have developed their own offerings, but we're seeing a very large swath of clients that want to be in the marketplace of providing those services to their clients. And they've chosen to engage providers like Epiq to provide managed services. So where we take our technology stack and we provide it to a law firm as effectively, and it could be like a white label solution so that you could actually put your services around that or offer that services to your clients. And you can continue to manage or control that end-to-end service experience for your clients. So that's the third area that we see growing very rapidly and we think will be a significant growth going forward. And then the final area, and this is more to our corporate audiences, we're seeing them ask for doing e-discovery spend analysis. How much are they spending and how can they get far more efficient in how they spend their dollars? And we're ramping up rapidly to be able to provide those services to our clients. And then, you know, just very briefly, this leads to something that we see going on, and this comes from, you know, my technology background, and the gentleman that leads our legal solutions, his name is Roger Peltz. I brought him on board 6 months ago, very strong technical leader, just overall fantastic leader. And he's got a vision that he's seen evolve in other technology industries. You know, we both came from the technology background where CIOs, chief information officers, 15 years ago, used to grapple with managing all this technology. How do you do it? And over the course of, you know, years, solutions were developed called around IT asset management, and frameworks were developed on how do you manage all those assets. We see this, you know, playing a game in how matter management is done for large corporate clients and how law firms play into that. So we're just starting to see the front edge of that, and it's something that we're very interested in as a company and leading over the next number of years.